All right, everybody's been talking about the local TV news giant Sinclair Broadcast Company and this promise to go beyond fake news mission statement that the company had dozens of its news anchors read. Now the company is defending itself and stands behind its message despite critics who say Sinclair is spoon-feeding talking points of President Trump. Is this a big deal or not? Here are the facts. You decide.
Our greatest responsibility is to serve our Treasure Valley communities.
This month, nearly 200 local TV news stations owned by the Sinclair Broadcast Company started running this promotional script.
Plaguing our country.
It's the same read for every market, just with each market's local anchors voicing the words.
The sharing of biased and false news
has become all too common on social media.
But when Deadspin gathered up all the promos and cut them together, the story turned viral.
And this is extremely dangerous to our democracy.
Media critics and Democratic lawmakers lambasted Sinclair, which, according to some Sinclair employees, mandates airing political opinion pieces by former Trump aides. Former CBS News anchor Dan Rather tweeted a script read by a, quote, corporate overlord, end quote, isn't journalism. He calls it Orwellian. Others calling this President Trump's propaganda. Well, Sinclair is firing back, saying this promotional message was in response to the public's distrust in news generally. Backed by a Monmouth University study reporting more than three-quarters of Americans believe traditional major TV and newspaper outlets report, quote-unquote, fake news. Sinclair's senior VP of news saying, quote, "We aren't sure of the motivation for the criticism, but find it curious that we would be attacked for asking our news people to remind their audiences that unsubstantiated stories exist on social media, which result in ill-informed public with potentially dangerous consequences," end quote.
I think it's a story.
We talked with Scott Libin, former local TV news director, journalism professor at the U, and chairman of the Radio TV Digital News Association.
These words really couldn't offend any principled journalist. You look through this statement, which I think was painstakingly vetted, and you can't find anything in there to oppose. So the content of this commentary is not the issue.
So then what happened? And why does it seem icky to a lot of people then?
Two things. It seems icky for one thing because it does echo the president's even broader brush smear of journalism. But secondly, and maybe even more powerfully, it indicates that these anchors that viewers want to think of as their neighbors, people they trust, are being told what to say by some distant, faceless, centralized corporation who maybe they don't trust. People are skeptical of journalists. They're distrustful. And in some ways, that's probably a good thing. Journalists ought to be accountable for their own behavior. Journalists love to hold the powerful accountable. Journalists are the powerful in many ways, and they too ought to be held accountable.
What do you tell students right now who see the coverage of Sinclair or have doubts or are dubious about certain stations?
Yeah.
What are you telling them?
Well, I tell them what I tell any news consumer is you ought to shop carefully. You ought to be a shrewd consumer of news. You ought to get your news from a number of different places so you can compare it and decide who deserves your business and your trust.
All right, we want to hear from you. What do you think about the company-wide promotion? Too far or right on? Hit us up on the BTN 11 Facebook page, or you can tweet us with the hashtag BTN 11. We'll be right back.